As economists estimate, inflation picked up for a fourth straight month in May due to unfavorable base effects and higher power rates. The consensus, May's consumer price index likely hitting or even topping 4%, which is the upper end of government's target range, though still within the Banco Central's own forecast range for the month of 3.7 to 4.5%. The Philippine Statistics Authority will release its May inflation print this Wednesday, that's tomorrow, and as always, ANC will carry that live. So, what could this mean to policy rates? The Banco Central is expected to keep rates unchanged during its next policy review happening on June 27th. Of course, the governor, Ely De Molina, earlier said they may cut rates as early as August, even ahead of the Fed, possibly by 25 basis points. The Monetary Board has kept its key policy rate steady at a 17-year high of 6.5% for five straight meetings already, after having raised borrowing costs by a whopping, this is the most aggressive, 450 basis points from May 2022 to October 2023 to tame stubborn inflation, again making the BSP one of the most aggressive in the region and in the world. The Philippines slapping a temporary ban on live cattle and meat imports from the United Kingdom, this after mad cow disease was detected in Scotland. The Agriculture Department says the disease could cause fatal nerve damage in cattle, and its possible spread in the country could undermine the livestock industry and compromise food safety. The agency, however, notes all shipments from the UK that were already in transit or accepted into ports would be allowed entry, provided these were slaughtered or produced before April 10 this year. Shifting gears now, South Korean tech giant Kakao and Japan's LINE unveil a new blockchain platform in the Philippines. Kaya, set to be formally launched in the coming months, it's expected to be among the largest blockchain platforms in Asia. Kakao's blockchain arm, Clayton Foundation, says they will focus on the Philippine gaming industry, which is a big sector for the country. It will also expand to other sectors or industries as it looks for more local partners like the leading cryptocurrency brand in the country, Coins.ph.
And our strategy is to localize our blockchain and also our localize our ecosystem and DApps based on different countries. To reach out to these people, in a sincere way, we have to understand, we have to make them understand ourselves.
Cryptocurrency as a whole, if you don't understand it, it's a risky form of digital asset. So that's why for Coins.ph, what we've been doing through until now or in all of our campaigns is that we make sure that the market or the people will get to understand first the space that they're being at.
As longtime Alliance Global Group executive King Son Sian officially retires, Kevin Tan, the son of founder Andre Tan and currently CEO and vice chairman of AGI, will be serving the unexpired term of Sian as president of the company. Sian, who headed Newport World Resorts under Travelers International, had served as director, president, and COO of parent AGI. Meanwhile, for those who missed it, Philippine Airlines is kicking off its Independence Day seat sale to last until June 16. It offers special one-way regular economy base fares for as low as 208 pesos for travel on select domestic flights within the September to January 2025 period, and special round-trip economy base fares as low as $85 for travel on select international flights. And we have this, Justin. The Regional Trial Court of Makati City has promulgated a decision finding officers of delisted Galata Corporation guilty of market manipulation. Officers of delisted company, including its chairman, president, and CEO Joseph Galata, have been sentenced to pay fines totaling 8 million pesos or serve time in prison if unable to do so for making misleading and exaggerated statements about its supposed Mactan Leisure City project, thereby inducing the public to buy the company's shares back in 2016. That was 8 years ago. Mactan Leisure City was supposed to start operations in 2020 and was expected to generate some 56 billion in gross annual revenues. Trading volume in Galata shares surged by 2,455% on the same day the subject disclosures were made, followed by a 196% jump in the next trading day. These statements were disclosed despite the fact that no application for a license had been made to PAGCOR for the same project.